옛날 인터콥 로고예요.
So the left side is an InterCP old logo.
제가 이 왼쪽 로고를 어제 키스한 유튜버인 가서 보여줬어요.
So I showed the kids and the youth old logo at the kids in the gallery.
저 글자가 뭔지 읽어봐라.
And I asked them to read it.
했더니 한 뭐 몇백 명 중에 한 다섯 명이 읽었어요.
Out of the hundreds of people, maybe like five people were able to read it.
한글이니까.
Because it's Korean.
그러니까 다섯 명 읽은 애들은 한국 사람이죠.
So the five kids that read it are Korean.
나머지는 못 읽어요.
The rest of them can't read it anymore.
그래서 내가 애들한테 복창시켰어요.
So I asked them to do it again.
따라해봐라.
I asked them to follow after.
나는 아메리칸.
I am American.
너는 한국 애들이 아니야.
You're not Korean.
한국말도 모르는 사람.
You don't even know Korean.
패스포트 미국.
Their passport is American.
그리고 태어난 건 미국.
And they were born in America.
Mother language, American.
Mother tongue is American, English.
인터콥도 모르면서.
And they don't even know, they can't even read inter-CP in Korean.
한국 애들이 아니라.
You can no longer be Korean, call Koreans anymore. You're Americans now.
그래, 엄청 기뻐하셨죠.
And they were so happy.
하여튼 인터콥 한국말에 있었던 로고를.
So this inter-CP Korean logo.
오른쪽으로 바꿨어요.
We changed it into the one on the right.
Inter-CP International.
So it's now called inter-CP International.
그럼 명칭을 바꾼 게 아닙니다.
So we didn't just change the name.
우리 쓸데없이 명칭 바꾸잖아요.
You don't just change the name because of our fickle hearts.
명칭을 바꿨다는 뜻은 인터콥 전체를 뒤집는 겁니다.
What it means to change the name, it means that we're completely changing the organization right now.
그렇게 하라고 글로벌 얼라이언스 때 말씀하셨어요.
And he said this to us during the Global Alliance Conference to do this.
마지막 1,000명 외국인이 마지막 따로 시켰을 때.
So when we had a separate gathering for the 1,000 foreigners that came.
제가 마지막 기도회를 인도했는데.
I was praying and I was leading the prayer.
정말 주님 말씀하셨어요.
The final prayer and God really told us.
이 시간에 글로벌 얼라이언스의 목숨을 바칠 자를 일으켜라.
So you must raise up the people who will put their lives on the line for Global Alliance.
그걸 계시라고 그러잖아요.
And we call these things revelations.
생각도 안 하는데.
I wasn't even thinking of this.
갑자기 뭔가 말씀하셔서 하라고.
But all of a sudden he talked to me, he spoke to me, and he told me to do something.
시킨 대로 했어요.
So I did what he told me to do.
제가 외국인들 오신 분한테.
So to the foreigners that came.
감동과 은혜를 받았으니.
I was so touched in my heart, and I was so blessed.
마지막 글로벌 아이스에 생명을 바칠 자 일어나세요.
And I told them, whoever wants to put their lives on the line for this final global alliance, rise up from your seat.
그 말이 통역되자마자. 하셨습니다.
The moment this was interpreted, everyone rose up from their seats.
여러분도 일어나신 거예요.
So you rose up too then.
제가 대표해서 일어났습니다.
Because I rose up representing you guys.
그리고 우리 글로벌 아이스의 마지막 목숨을 바치기로 했습니다.
And we promise that we will give all of our lives for this final global alliance.
어제 키스 애들이 기도했습니다.
And the kids generation prayed yesterday.
세계의 교회가 하나가 되게 하셨어요.
Let the global church become one.
하나님의 뜻이 한 몸입니다.
And the heavenly will is for us to become one body.
한 몸이요.
To become one body.
하나가 아프면 다 아프고.
So when one part of the body is sick, then the rest of the body is sick.
한쪽이 영광이면 다 함께 영광이고.
And if one part of the body receives glory, then all of the body is honored too.
모든 걸 함께 한 몸.
It is everything. We do everything together as one body.
이곳에 마지막 모든 모습을 바친 몸.
And for this, we give all of our lives, our final life.
여러분, 19세기는 선교의 위대한 세대.
So the 19th century was the great mission era.
The great century라고 합니다.
We call it the great century.
18세기에 모라비안 어마어마한 부흥이 시작됐고.
In the 19th century, we saw the great Moravian mission movement.
모라비안 부흥이 세계를 덮었어.
And this Moravian revival covered over all of the world.
모라비안 부흥을 받은 자가 요한 웨슬리입니다.
And the ones that received this great revival was John Wesley.
미국 선교사의 실패를 가슴에 안고 구원도 받지 못했다 절망에 빠진 그가 모라비안 올더스케이트 교회에서 마틴 루터 서문 1장을 듣다가 엄청난 깨달음을 풍을 받았어요.
And John Wesley, when he was very furious about the failure about the American missionaries, when he was hearing for the first part of the Martin Luther speech, he rose up in this anger.
그 받았던 은혜의 장소가 모라비안교회입니다.
And he received this blessing also in the Moravian Church.
그리고 영국 전체를 부흥시켰어요.
And he brought great revival upon the British Church.
영국의 부흥을 타고 19세기 위대한 선교사들이 열망을 낳은 겁니다.
And with the revival in UK as the start, we saw the start of the great mission era in which this revival spread throughout the whole world.
19세기의 선교사님들은 다 영국.
So all of the missionaries in the 19th centuries are heroes.
시대가 영웅들을 낳은.
And this era gave birth to these heroes.
이들은 전부 개척자들.
Why? Because they were all pioneers.
한 번도 가지 않은 길을 길을 내며 갔던 자들.
They made and paved their path in this path that no one has been to before.
엄청. 엄청난 희생을 치렀어요.
And they gave great sacrifice for this.
영국의 알렉산더 맥케나 선교사가 짐바브웨를 떠나면서
So Alexander McKay, Bishop Alexander McKay, as he was going to Zimbabwe,
8명의 선교사 파송이 됐대.
In the mission commissioning ceremony of 8 missionaries.
여러분들은 3개월 지나지 않아서 8명 중에 한 명의 사망 소식을 듣게 될 겁니다.
So after 3 months, you will probably hear that one of the 8 people that have been commissioned has died.
절대 실망하지 마시고.
Do not be disappointed by this.
한 명이 죽었으니 한 명을 다시 보내 8명을 채워주셔야 됩니다.
Since one person has died, may you send another person so he may be 8 again.
그 말 하자마자 예언되어서 결국 3개월 내에 한 명이 죽었어요.
And when he spoke this, it became a prophecy. And before 3 months passed, one person died.
1년 내 5명이 죽었어요.
And within 1 year, 5 people died.
2년 내 8명 중에 알렉산더 맥케이 빼고 7명 다 죽었어요.
And then 2 years later, with the exception of missionary Alexander McKay, all the rest of the 7 died.
그 자신도 12년째 풍토병으로 죽었어요.
And he also died because of the local illnesses within 8 years.
그때 19세기의 선교사들이 아프리카 대륙을 위해 얘기할 때
And in the 19th century when the missionaries were speaking about the African continent
천명이 죽어도
Even thousands of people died
반드시 아프리카 살려야 된다
We must bring life to Africa
이게 19세기의 선교사들이었어요
And these were the missionaries of the 19th century
Hudson Taylor
David Livingston
한반도에 우리 아펜젤러 언더우드 선교사까지
Missionary Appenzeller and Underwood came to the Korean Peninsula
위대한 선교사들이었어요.
And they were the great missionaries of the 19th century.
그래서 19세기를 the great century라고 합니다.
That is why we call the 19th century the great century.
그 엄청난 부흥이 북미에 데리고 왔어.
And this great revival came to the North American continent.
20세기는 북미의 어마어마한 선교 시대입니다.
And the 20th century is the great era of mission revival.
그래서 부르기를 20세기는 the greatest century.
So that we call the 20th century the greatest century.
이유는 북미에서 학생 자원으로 2만 명이 나왔고
Why? Because through the student volunteer movement in North America where the 20,000 people went out
이 북미의 선교사는 19세기를 능가했어요
And the missionaries from America, they superseded the missionaries from the 19th century
전 세계를 향해서 엄청난 세계적인 선교를 하셨습니다
And they had a very systematic approach in doing missions to the whole world
성경 전체를 민족을 향해 번역을 시작했고
And they started to translate the Bible into all different languages
20세기의 선교는 위대한 결실을 낳았어요
And the 20th century, this great mission, greatest mission era gave birth to great missions
20세기의 중국 전체가 부흥했고
And the 20th century, all of China came into revival
인도교도 8천만 명을 통한
The Indian church, they saw great revival of 80 million people
한국도 부흥했고
The Korean church saw great revival
전체가 아프리카가 부흥했어
And all of Africa saw revival too
위대한 20세기의 선교가
And the great mission of the 20th century
위대한 세계 선교를 성취해버립니다
It accomplished great world mission
그래 북미의 20세기 선교는 the great century
So the 20th century in America became the great century
21세기가 됐어요
And now it is the 21st century
21세기는 the greatest century
Now the 21st century is the greatest century
아멘을 아는 자들을 반드시 평생 선교사로 보내십시오.
And everyone who did not say Amen, God may you send them as lifelong missionaries.
이유는?
Why?
우리 YG 복음을 들었잖아요.
So you heard and saw the YG.
21세기는 북미 선교 시대 아니에요.
The 21st century it is not just about North America mission movement.
북미뿐이 아니고.
It is not only North America.
중남미.
Latin America.
아시아.
Asia.
심지어 이슬람권 중국까지.
Islamic regions, the Middle East,
Africa, 전대로,
and all of the African countries,
Australia,
Russia, Russia,
온 세계 교회가 다 함께 순교할 시대입니다.
It is an era in which the global church, all this mission work together.
그리고 끝내주세요.
And it is an era in which we will complete this.
아멘. 제가 선교사를 보니까
So when we look into mission history
19세기의 The Great Century를 주도했던 영국교회 선교단체
The mission organizations from Britain that led the mission revival in the 19th century
결국 국제단체를 벌였어요
In the end they all became international organizations
하려고 한 게 아니고
They did not intend to become one
열심히 선교했더니
But as they were diligently doing mission
헌신과 믿음을 전 세계교회 확장에 길을 빼버린 겁니다
They expanded and spread their faith and their commitment to all of the global church and the global church broke a loop because of
그래서 왜 인터내셔널 China.
So why do we say international now?
OMF China Mission.
OMF China Mission.
그래 전 세계 단체거든.
And OMF became a global organization.
20세기를 보니.
And when we look at the 20th century.
북미 선교 어마어마한 시대다.
It was the great mission era of North America.
선교했던 단체들이 다 국제 단체가 되는 거예요.
All of the mission organizations that served this became an international organization.
CCC가 국제 단체를 세운 게 아닙니다.
So CCC did not originally start as an international organization.
빌 프라이 박사님은 미국 캠퍼스를 위해 세운 거예요.
Professor Bill Rice, he started it for the North American campus.
열심히 섬겼어요.
And he really diligently served it.
어느 날 나이지리아 목사님 찾았대요.
One day a Nigerian pastor came to him.
너무 열심히 생각하는 거 보니까.
We see you such diligently, working so diligently.
나이지리아도 캠퍼스 깨워야 되겠습니다.
We have to awaken the Nigerian campus.
그것 때문에 나이지리아 CCC 시작됐대요.
And that is why we saw CCC start in Nigeria.
어느 날 김정국 목사님 찾았대요.
And one day Pastor Kim came to find him.
너무 한국 캠퍼스도 필요하니까.
But we need this so much in the Korean campuses.
나도 한국 캠퍼스 살리겠습니다.
I will also bring life back into the Korean campuses.
그래서 CCC가 국제가 됐더니.
And that is how CCC became an international organization.
그럼 YM 예수 전도단.
YM.
세계 단체 세운 게 아닙니다.
They did not start off as an international organization.
미국 교회와 미국 캠퍼스 성교도 시작한 거예요.
They started a mission movement in the American churches and the campuses.
근데 어느 날 갑자기 주님이 확장해 버립니다.
But all of a sudden one day God he expanded what they were doing.
그래서 YM 이름을 바꿨답니다.
So they changed the name of YM.
YM Global White.
YM Global White.
Wycliffe Global Alliance.
Wycliffe Global Alliance.
CCC Crusade. 이 사람들 안 되겠다.
CCC Campus Crusaders. We can't use this in the Islamic regions.
그래서 크루.
So they changed it into crew.
우리가 Global Alliance 섬기다 보니.
And as we start Global Alliance.
이미 함께하고 있고.
And we are all already together.
YG를 보니.
And when we see our YG.
이미 모든 유럽 중남미를 다니고 있고.
They are already going into Europe and Latin America.
여러분 이 중남미 유럽 대장정을 따라오고 싶으시죠?
So you guys also want to go to the Europe and Latin America BTJ Back to Jesus tours, right?
기쁨 공부 내릴까 막 같이 하고 싶으시잖아요.
You're so excited and passionate about it. You want to partake in this too, right?
절대 따라가시면 안 돼요.
You cannot go with them though.
가정이 깨져요.
Why? Because of your families.
남편이 도망가 버리시고.
Your husband, they run away.
애들이 부모를 잊어버리세요.
And the children, they will forget who their parents are.
절대 기도만 하시면 따라가시면 안 돼요.
So just pray for them, don't follow them.
잠시 참여하고 빨리 돌아오세요.
You can go and visit them for a while and then come back.
이런 사역은 YG가 아닙니다.
These kind of ministries are for the YG.
제가 보니까
so when I look at them,
유럽, 중남미, 전부 깨우는데
Latin America, they are awakening all everywhere.
목사가 오고 있는 게 아닙니다 지금.
It's not pastors that are doing this.
저희가 오고 있는 게 아니에요.
It's not us that are doing this.
저도 한번 참석했는데
I bet you it was.
제가 한 일은
What I did was
가서 니카라가 목사님들한테
I told the Nicaragua pastors
목사님들
pastors
이 청년들이 맞아요.
These YG, what they're saying are right.
이게 제 역할이에요.
This is what I'm supposed to do. That's my role.
제가 와서 뭐 강의한 게 아니고
I don't give a lecture there.
숟가락만 딱 얹어가지고
I just have to add in that like final finishing point.
이 청년들이 맞아.
Oh, what the YG are saying.
이 청년들 얘기 들어보세요.
Just hear what the YG are saying.
이게 우리 역할이에요.
This is what my role is.
지금 중남미 유럽 전체를 개척하는 건
Latin America and Europe, it is all being pioneered.
20대 청년들입니다.
Because of the YG in their 20s.
근데 부흥 역사를 보시면
But if you look at the history of mission revival
이제 위대한 부흥
When you see all of the great mission revival,
그걸 시작한 전 에반 로버츠는 20대 청년이었어요.
Evan Roberts, he was in his 20s.
그와 함께 전체 레이즈를 부르신 엄청난 설교자들은
And the many, many people that actually fought a great revival into these foreign lands
다 19세, 20대 청년이었어요.
They were young people, YG, from the 19th and 20th century.
이거 엄청난 헌신이 필요하고
And we need great, great commitment for this.
어마어마한 체력이 필요하고
And we need a lot, lot of physical strength for this.
하나님은 강력한 믿음이 필요하고
And we need great faith for this.
따라하시면 순교하시고
So if you follow them, you'll become martyrs.
그러니까 마음껏 축복해 주시고
So bless them with all of your heart.
주시고
And be with them.
청년들을 믿어주시고
And you have to trust the YG.
결국 주님께 청년을 움직여 세계를 깨우는 거예요.
In the end, God, he will move the YG in order to awaken the global church.
예수님께서는 어떻게 홀로 오셔서 온 세계를 바꾸셨을까요?
How did Jesus come alone onto this earth and change the whole entire world?
30대 청년으로 3년 만에 인류권을 완성하시고 세계를 바꾸셨어요.
Jesus, he came at age 30, he was a YG, and within 3 years, he completed the history of salvation, and he completely changed the world.
어떤 생각 가졌을까요?
What kind of thoughts did he have in his head?
그걸 율법사가 와서 묻는 거예요.
And a teacher of the law asked him.
율법사는 답을 알아요.
The teacher of the law knew the answer to the question.
아는 답을 아는 걸 시험하려고 왔습니다.
And he knew the answer to the question, and he was trying to test Jesus if he knew it.
하나님의 계명 중에
Out of all the commandments of God,
가장 큰 계명이 무엇입니까?
What is the most important commandment?
예수님 대답하셨어요.
And Jesus, he answered this question.
하나님을 마음과 목숨과 뜻을 다해 사랑하고
You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might.
둘째도 여같으니 내 이웃을 내 몸처럼 사랑하라.
And second is like it, you shall love your neighbor as yourself.
이는 온 율법과 선지자의 감명입니다.
On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets.
이 정답을 율법이 율법사가 갖고 있는 답과 똑같았을까요?
And was this answer the same answer that the teacher of the law was speaking of?
시험하게 왔습니까?
The teacher of the law was there to test.
율법사가 알고 있던 답과 이 대답 똑같았을까요?
The answer that the teacher of the law was speaking about and this answer that Jesus gave were they the same?
물론 성경 말씀이 없지만.
Of course, in the Bible, it does not detailly explain this.
확신합니다.
But I'm pretty sure.
완전히 달랐어.
That it was completely different.
달라요.
It's probably completely different.
만약 율법사가 이 답을 갖고 있었다면
If the teacher of the law actually had this answer
절대 사람을 말의 얼굴로 잡지 않아
He would not try to trap these people, Jesus with his words
말을 잡아 얼굴을 씌우는 자는 악한 자들입니다
And those who try to trap people with their words are evil people
제가 하는 얘기가 아니고
I'm not saying this with my own words
마태복음 22장에 오늘 나와요
In Matthew chapter 22 it says this
사람들이 예수를 시험할 때
And people when they try to test Jesus
말을 잡아 얼굴을 씌우려고 왔습니다
They are trying to trap Jesus through his words
그걸 보험서에 악하다고 기록하셨어요
And in the Gospels it says that this is wicked
만약 율법사 안에 정말 이 계명이 살아있다면
If the teacher of the law really had this commandment living inside of him
그는 절대 사람을 시험하잖아요
He would not have tested people
절대 사람을 말에 얼굴을 씌우잖아요
He would not try to trap people with their words
그러니까 그는 다른 말씀을 갖고 있었던 겁니다
So he probably was thinking of other words
예를 들면 쉐마 신명기 6장 4절
So for example, Shema, Deuteronomy 16:4
이스라엘아 들으라 여호와 하나님은 유일하신 여호와시
Israel, listen, Jesus as God, He is the one and only God.
그러니까 의로운 분들로 모든 불의를 향해 일어나는 겁니다.
And so these righteous people, they all go towards this unrighteousness.
근데 그 말씀의 본체이신 예수님은 달라요.
But Jesus, who was the Word Himself, was different.
예수님의 첫째 가장 큰 개념은
The first and biggest commandment of our Lord.
그의 천상을 움직이는 생명의 말씀은
It, the Word that really moves His life.
그 많은 성경 말씀 중에 가장 위대한 말씀.
And the greatest word out of all of his words
마음을 다하고 목숨을 다하고 뜻을 다해 하나님 아버지를 사랑하라
You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind
예수님의 삶 전체가 됐습니다
And all of Jesus' life depicted this
아버지가 원하십니다
If the Father desires for this
어디든지 가셨습니다
I will, he went to anywhere he, the Father desires
아버지가 원하십니다
And when the Father desired something
어떤 집도 방문하셨습니다
He would go into any house
아버지가 원하니
And when the Father desired this
이 어둠 세상에 오셨습니다
He came into this darkness. According to His will, He sacrificed Himself on that cross.
예수님과 처음 마지막 모든 것이 다 하나님을 향한 마음과 목숨과 뜻을 향한 사랑이었어.
Jesus, from the beginning to the end, it was loving God with all His heart, His soul, and His mind.
둘째는 이와 같은.
And the second is like this.
정말 예수님은 이웃을 사랑하셨어.
And Jesus, He really loved His neighbors.
시험하러 오는 자들에게도 항상 진리를 말씀하셨습니다.
He always spoke the truth to those who was trying to test Him.
창기도 반갑게 맞으시고
And then He was also very, very nice and welcoming to the prostitutes.
배신자들도 함께 제자를 삼아주시고
And He even made betrayers His disciples.
어떤 죄인도 친구가 되어주셨습니다.
And He became the friends to sinners.
나오는 자를 절대 정죄 안 적으시고
And He never condemned anyone who came to Him.
목숨을 다해 그들을 사랑하셨습니다.
With all of His life, He loved them until the end.
그는 삶 전체가 이 말씀입니다.
And all of His life represented this word.
강력이란 뜻은
And this word powerful means
모든 것이 다 그것에 걸려있다는 뜻입니다.
It means that everything it depends on this.
예수님 말씀이
And Jesus He said
모든 성경 말씀은
Out of the whole entire Bible
이 위대한 계명에 걸려있다 강력이다.
It depends on this great commandment.
그래서 온 세상을 바꾸려고
So that is how He changed the entire world.
우리는 글로벌 라이스로 완성합니다.
So we will finish the global alliance.
세계 선교를 완성할 겁니다.
And we will finish global mission.
마라나타 주의 오심을 반드시 보게 될 거예요.
And Maranatha, we will see the return of the Lord.
교회는 승리할 겁니다.
The church will be victorious.
우리는 부흥할 거예요.
And we will be revival.
우리 부흥 주실 거예요.
And God, He will pour out revival.
우리 마침내 승리의 영광을 보게 될
것입니다. And we will see the glorious victory.
예수님처럼 하시.
We must follow Jesus.
머리부터 발끝까지.
From head to toe.
우리의 호흡과 모든 삶 전체가.
Our home and all of our life.
마음과 목숨과 뜻을 다해 하나님 아버지를 사랑하시.
We must love the Lord our God with all our heart, all our mind, and all our soul.
지상 명령으로 끝까지 달려갈 것입니다.
And we will run until the end for the great commandment. Why?
그걸 성취하면 아버지 하나님을 볼 수 있게 되죠.
Why, when we fulfill the great commission, we can see our Father God?
눈과 눈으로 그를 함께 만나시지 않겠습니까?
We can meet Him eye to eye.
가슴이 터지고,
our hearts seem like they're going to
explode,
and our tears would burst out.
우리가 사랑을 고백하지 않겠습니까?
And we will confess our love with all that we have.
땅 끝까지 예수의 증인으로 살 것.
And we will live as witnesses of Jesus Christ to the end of
the world.
Why?
첫 번째, 모든 민족을 사랑.
Firstly, we love all nations.
두 번째, 사랑하는 예수님을 함께 만나 영원의 천국 잔치에 참여하지 않겠습니까?
And secondly, we will meet the Jesus Christ we love, and we will partake in that heavenly banquet forever.
지금도 감격되는 것은.
So right now, I'm even so happy because.
하나님께서 영원토록 하나님 아버지를 사랑.
We can in heaven love our God forever eternally.
영원토록 모든 형제자매를 몸처럼 사랑.
And we can love our brothers like ourselves eternally in heaven.
완전한 구원 에터널.
And we can enter into this completed salvation.
우리의 모든 삶.
And all of our ministry.
모든 사명.
And all of our mission.
이 엄청난 사랑의 계명에 달려 있어.
It depends on this great commandment of love.
그 자들만 끝까지 승리하게 될 것이.
And these people only will be victorious until end.
온통 사랑에 불타는 자들만.
Those who are on fire with this love.
글로벌 원하였으나 성취합니다.
They will fulfill global minds.
그 자들이 바로 주님의 오심을 보게 될 것이.
And they will see the return of our Lord.
아멘.
아멘.
우리 함께 시간 일어나 기도하시겠습니다.
So let us rise from our seats and pray at this time.
우리 전체를 다 마음을 열시라.
So let us all open our hearts.
때론 연약함을 느끼고.
Sometimes we feel weak.
때론 엄청난 사역의 팀 앞에 너무나 우리가 작음을 느끼고.
Sometimes before this great ministry, we see how small.
주님께서는 길을 보여주셨어요.
God, He has shown us the way.
예수님께서는 진리를 말씀하셨습니다.
Jesus, He spoke of the truth.
그분도 우리의 생명이 되어주셨어요.
And He became our life.
어떻게 예수님 홀로 이 땅에 오셔서?
How Jesus came to this earth alone.
진흙 같은 모든 민족을 바꾸셨을까요?
And how did He change all of the darkest nations?
엄청난 전략을 얘기하신 게 아닙니다.
He did not speak of great strategies.
어마어마한 이야기에 빠지신 게 아닙니다.
He did not speak of great, great, amazing things.
온 세계 민족의 엄청난 역사 앞에.
Before the great history of all nations.
예수님의 분명한 말씀의 능력을.
The great and powerful and very clear power of the word of Jesus Christ.
이 말씀에 온통 걸리는 거예요.
Everything is depend on this.
무엇을 해봐.
Whatever we do.
어떤 자를 만나든.
And whoever we meet.
어느 순간조차도.
Every single moment we face.
마음과 목숨과 뜻을 다해 하나님 아버지를 정말 사랑하셨습니다.
You shall love the Lord your God, God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. And this is what Jesus did.
무시 당할 때도 절대 흔들리지 않으셨어요.
When he was despised, he was never shaken.
칭찬받는 자 절대 그만하지 않으셨어요.
And when he was complimented, he was never arrogant.
그의 마음속에 하나님 아버지 온통 가득 차 있었어요.
And his heart was filled with God.
하나님 아버지의 뜻을 따라 온 생명을 이웃을 위해 바쳐주셨어요.
According to the will of God, he gave all of his life to love his neighbors.
한 죄인을 향해 자기의 모든 모습을 내주셨고.
And for that one sinner, he gave everything that he had.
찾아오는 모든 죄들을 다 생명으로 받으셨어요.
And he received all of the sinners that came to him with life.
어떤 자도 시험하지 않으셨어요.
He did not test any single person.
이유는 그의 모든 생의 말씀이 사람의 말씀에 걸렸습니다.
Why? Because each and every single law and commandment of his life was depending on this word of love.
그리스도의 사랑이 이긴 겁니다.
So the love of Christ overcame.
그리스도의 사랑이 열방을